Hello, farmers. It's Trevor here, and I am back for another episode on Grizzly Mountain, Lazy Farmer. And once again, I've been anything but lazy. We have done quite a bit while in between the episodes, just because I think the vast majority of it would have been boring. We planted some sugar beets. The reason I did that is because if we came in and looked, I said, well, the root crops drive me up a wall is a general statement. That's the wrong button. And if you come in here and look at the potato technology, there's not a huge, you know, number of options. This guy, you know, he does the trick. He's not that bad, but he'd also cost us 25 grand to rent, and he's just an expensive piece of equipment. I know there's some other mods out there, but again, I'm being a little bit lazy. I'm allowed to in this series. And then I started looking at this and saying, well, you know what? There's quite a few more options that would actually cost us, you know, significantly less. You're talking about doing 9 meters at a stroke. You know, so we could probably do these a lot cheaper. I don't plan on doing a lot because that's like work, you know. And this is about being lazy. In any event, another thing I did to this field was, if you look, there we go, I got it fixed up. If you watched an episode before, I forget which one it was, you'll know that this was a bit of a mess. But anyway, I think I have the field looking like I would normally. So I think if I create another field, I'll just run around it and plant some grass and then come back and roller what I don't want to be right in the field, and it should look pretty good. If we come over here, our corn is doing well. Don't have any weeds in it just yet, or I didn't last time I looked. I don't see any in there. You know what? That's right. We did spray it one time. I don't know if they're going to... They do tend to come back at a certain point, so... Hello, bush. And then the other thing I did was... I'm pretty sure I did this after the episode. Not 100% sure. Let's go swim across the river here real quick. I move faster in the river, I think, than I do on land. Is I planted soybeans. So just for a different crop. Plus, I think we can use the soybeans for the pigs. So we've got corn that I know we can use on the pigs. We've got sugar beets, which I know we can use for the pigs. And another thing. Let's see if we can jump. Yeah, let's jump down here. Why not? I went around and I also tried to fix the grass on this field. Now, what I did at times was, you know, figuring, well, it's all just grass. Like, I backed the thing in here so that I could fix this little spot that I was going to, like, I rollered this part out. I think you can see the difference in the color. And then this part's part of the field. But now that I just went to cut the grass, like, this didn't cut. You see that? It looks like it's part of the field. I don't know why it wouldn't cut at that point. I mean, it's... You know, if we look at our map, oops, let's move this down and turn the grass on. Come in here, you can see it's, you know, over, you know, what do you call it, fertilized. Same thing with like a little area down here. It's because I had gone back over it with the fertilizing thing, but there's, oops, that wasn't showing you the growth, was it? You know, it doesn't say harvested. Oh, you know what? It does look like a light green. Maybe that's the problem. The rest of the field got to the yellow. Never mind. Thank you, guys. You helped me figure that out. All right. So this just wasn't ready to cut yet. That's why it didn't get cut. Same thing over here. This wasn't, you know, this was all yellow. And because this was just the first color of green or whatever color of green, it wasn't harvestable. Okay. Not the greatest graphic, or not the greatest grass thing in the world there, is it? Oh, well. Well, good. At least we figured out that great mystery. So, in any event, I cut this whole field, and then I tethered it. So, does it say? Yeah, it says fruit-type grass, which makes sense, but this is actually tethered. So, we're ready to try another windrow course. And I wanted to talk about, you know, if you guys watched, I think it was 2 episodes ago, get our course play, I'm sorry, guidance steering going. We will try to get course play. So we want the east-west, but we can't use it until we come back. You know what? Let's try this. I just updated the course play and the guidance steering. So I have the latest, you know, latest and greatest. Let's see if this... Yep, look at that. So I don't think it's because I switched back and forth in there. But before, I'd have to go in, do the north-south one, get the east-west. Now I want to try another little experiment. So I'm going to start unfolding this guy. X, and then I'm going to hit Alt-R. Yeah, see, look, it did it narrow. So it's definitely doing that. I want to show you something else. Watch this. I'm going to turn this guy. I'm going to hit Alt-R again. And I don't know how well you guys can see it. Hopefully you can. But there's a red line. There's an offset now. So you have to be a little bit careful that you don't set yourself up with an offset. But hey, that's great news. One of the reasons I actually chose that plow, other than, you know, like the subsoiler as opposed to a plow, was because there was no offset on this GPS. So, and without that, that's just, to me, that's just sort of torturous, you know. So let's pull straight ahead so we can get a nice R reading here. There you go. And then we'll hit Alt. Always get that wrong. I don't think I've ever picked the right direction for this thing on the first shot. All right, so we move over to where we're... That doesn't seem right. Does it? Yeah, maybe it is. Let's back up. I just want to see if... Make sure it looks like it's the right width. Yeah, I guess it is. I'm probably still off the line. The last time we tried it, we tried going down this row like this. And the reason I did that is because I didn't want to hit the trees with the thing. But I'm a good enough driver that I could do that. Because we're going to try to record this course again. I didn't bother doing the tedding or the whatever. But one of the probably the biggest mistake that had me quitting the last time was that when we came up to here, we went around it. And then the course play course, instead of following... ended up going around in the wrong direction and all that stuff. So what I decided to do this time is I want to come over here, and this time it doesn't matter which way I move it, so I couldn't be wrong. But I just want to put this in about the middle. And then that way, when we get up to this point, we're just going to do a zigzag. You know, we're not going to try to do that fancy around. Now what that's going to do is mean when it comes to doing, you know, this line here, I'm just going to have to try to be accurate and not run into the tree. Which is, shouldn't be a problem. He says, right? Before catastrophe. All right, so part of the goal of this, you know, because this grass grows so often, it's one of the nice things that you can... All right, there we go. So start out in a good spot. One of the nice things to course play, because you're just going to be constantly dealing with this grass, because it's just growing and growing and growing. It's one of the reasons I put that, not growth control, but the growth state time, whatever. I did notice growth control is back. I don't know if it's... Somebody was complaining about it not working that well or something, but in any event, I didn't try. All right, so what we want to do here is record a course. Let's go back to where we started, a nice place. And I don't think it matters what kind of course we record at all. So I'm going to hit that it is field work, because it kind of is. And I'm going to do start course recording. And I'm going to turn this guy on. And then, now fortunately, you know, I kind of keep an eye on where that orange line is. It's pretty close to the tractor. And we make a nice straight line that way. You can actually just drive it. I kind of want to get rid of that thing. Yeah, let me hit B. Close this. Oop, 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 oop. Come on. There we go. Close. These other trees aren't quite as close for whatever reason. Especially those two kind of stick out. So what I'm going to do is try to do the same thing as before, where we just go up and down the rows as best we can, knowing that we're going to miss some. There. Should have swung it a little bit different. Now we're picking up that whole row over there, at least it appears like we are. Yeah, I think the reason that that was so bad was because it was a short turn, if you know what I mean. Like, I had to go. I probably shouldn't have done that. I probably should have done something different. But that's okay. You can see how we're out here harvesting crops. If we don't make a course play course that we like, you know, we can always just harvest the crops again and try to do better next time. That's what life's like anyway. Now, I'm really not going to get concerned if I miss something there. I'm just going to try not to hit rocks, and at least not ones that'll damage the vehicle. We might be able to pick that up, that little bit there, if we... Yeah, we didn't get it that time. See, so there's definitely going to be, you know, some spots that we missed at that point. But if you're that worried about every ounce of grass, then you can go back and do it manually once you set your guys to do it automatically, which is not an uncommon attitude to have, if you ask me. Like, it's really probably not a bad idea in any way to keep that attitude, because you expect course play or just the regular hired helpers to be spot on in the way they do things, you're just going to get yourself a little bit upset at times, I think. Because they certainly do dumb stuff. And by the way, recording your own courses like this is a good way to... they'll do what you set them up to do pretty well. This, I think, will work out reasonably. And I kind of don't know if my little maneuver there was positive or negative as far as missing some stuff. I think we're going to miss it on the other side. I think I turned a little bit too much. All right, well, let me finish this up, and then I'll come back and we'll take a look at how we do with the loader, which is really the part we failed on last time. All right, talk to you guys in a second. Okay, we are all windrowed up. Went pretty well. One of the things to note is that I ended up combining the last two rows, which I kind of like. The only issue is, if we come into our tractor here, not a big issue, but what it means... Oh, by the way, I got rid of all that other stuff we did before here. Let me move this one into this folder. So that's the cutting one we did before, which really I should get rid of because I kind of changed the dimensions a little bit when I did this thing. So we're just going to get rid of that. And then we only have two to deal with anyhow. So if we come in here and we load up this course, I got all the lines present. You can see that for us to start here and go all the way down there and come all the way back would be like just a complete waste of time. So we might as well just start this course over here, which I don't think would cause any problems. Now, I went and watched a few videos, and, you know, they, from what I could tell, they had it set on field work, you know, which is, I'm pretty sure, what it is. And then they just hit, like, we just hit this button, then they just hit this one. But the big difference is they didn't seem to have this line. All right, let me see. Let me get over there a little bit more. See this line that goes to the end? I didn't notice them having that line. And that line's like saying, oh, okay, well, I'm going to go from the end of this course to the beginning of this one. I didn't notice that at all. So I don't. They're doing something that I'm missing, and I probably should have tried. And then the other issue is, well, is this the same thing as FS17? Is it just something going on with this? So there you go. We got an awful lot of lines here. So what I think I'll do is, like I said, this is like the kind of the third row, but I should be able to start course at next closest waypoint. Now, where are you going? See that? I was definitely going to. It doesn't matter what you do in life. Yeah, so let's do something else. Nearest waypoint. There you go. All right, so the theory is that he would fill up, but I have almost no faith that this is going to work because we keep getting that line like it's going to expect to run that other course at the end of this one. Now, turn on field covers. While we're waiting, why don't we take a look and see. Stop at last point or next trigger. I don't really want to stop at the next trigger. Turn on field. I don't really know what that means. Maybe that prevent them from getting out of the field. That's more like settings for align with first waypoint. Path finding. Somebody had said something about this return to first point activated. I don't know, I forget whether they said you should deactivate it or whether you should activate it. And I'm not sure. Multiple tools, no, that's not, I can't see how that has anything. I don't know. We're going to give this a shot. If not, we're going to just finish it up all manually. Here, let's get rid of all these lines for now. Are we getting close to full? Yep. We're doing a pretty good job picking it up, if you notice that. I mean, it does tend to follow fairly well. The biggest thing you got to watch out for is just sometimes you'll go too fast, and this guy, if you make too sharp a turn, he'll lose where he's going. Nope. Yeah. And he stopped anyway. Covers automatic. Turn on field. I don't know. I will get it. I promise you guys. I will get it. But just not in this episode. I was hoping that the updated version would do the trick, you know? So let's, as a matter of fact, I'm just going to shut all that off. And I really don't even need those lines annoying me, because they're not going to be the right lines anyway. Let's get to the point where we don't crash. A lot of grass in the sheep pen there, huh? Which, now that I think about it, why don't we go buy some sheep? I think at this point we might just have them delivered. And we'll just give them this hay. Yeah, that'll make me happier after failing. So is there a best kind of sheep? Brown sheep, white sheep. You would think white sheep would have, or black and white sheep with the white wool would be the most desirable. Well, let's get black and white sheep. How many? It's three, four. Let's get 10, just so we know how much stuff we need for 10. How many we're allowed to have in a house? So that's 10 there, right? Fee, $1,000. Yeah, it's worth it for now. Hey, we've got animals. Woohoo! A lot of trees cutting down to get these animals. Let's go ahead and take a look at our escape animal thing. There we go, black and white sheep. Oh, water. We don't have any water for them. We better get them some water pretty quick, huh? So it doesn't matter. We could have just fed them grass or hay, huh? Shows you how much I know. But I know we'll need the hay for other animals. So are you better off doing one or the other? Here, you know what? Let me get rid of these lines too. Well, we'll give them hay, which you'd think, if anything, would be the better of the two. This looks more like a hay trough. Yep. Okay, well, they didn't need that much of that, did they? We better go get ourselves some water and stuff here pretty quickly. We'll dump this off first. I don't need to be this far zoomed out, do I? Okay, it's just that far zoomed out for the windrower. We're just gonna go get them some water ASAP. So let's come here and hit P. Go to trailers. I know it's under animals. That's milk trailers. So I think this is our only real option. We have 9,000. All right, let's run over to the shop. Now we don't have. Oh, you know what? I don't think I ever put back the water trough or the water. In one episode, I think I planted a water thing down there. I don't think I ever. I don't think I ever put it back after I redid things. So we'll have to put it back. I have no idea where you'd get water on this map, or if you even have water. I think if they put a free water thing, it'd be over here somewhere, wouldn't you? Sorry, we'll go place that now, so. Oop, oop, oop. ATM machine over there that I never noticed. I feel good about it. We got some sheep. Woohoo! It's amazing how some things make you so happy. It's been a good amount of work. I wish I remembered that you didn't. I don't think the grass does any different than the hay for the sheep. Now, let's think about the layout of our farm. I mean, these animals will be, if we have some horses may go right there, and I don't think it makes any difference. I think the only thing I would say is, I wonder if we could put it back where we had it. If you guys watched that episode, it was over here. So let's hit P. Not landscaping, this one. think it's under here. Yeah, water station. Oop, there was a little green. Boom, good enough. Yeah, that's fine. And I say good enough because I knew it would be... Like, I may end up with a road, and that road would probably be... Like, right along here. See what I mean? Like, depends on where that cow pasture is, but it's... There might be a road right there, and I knew this was going to be off, far enough up that it would be off of that road. At least I thought it would be. Yeah, that takes a while to fill, but I don't think we even need to fill it all the way up, do we? It's not costing us any money, so we might as well. Sheep, are you going to eat that grass down some? I'm kind of curious about that. Do they eat the grass and then it disappears? And if so, they shouldn't be eating the grass we worked hard for. Come on, baby. Let's hop out of here for a second. And I want to come back and look at this. Productivity 10%. Well, we got you water now. That should make you happier. And we can't give you grass and hay. We got to give you one or the other. So you should get your productivity up. I guess you're just not happy because you didn't have any water. So now my question is, how many pigs can we fit in one of these things? Let's go over to here. Animal pens. It's the bigger. Yeah, it's this one. Oh, we could get 250 of the buggers, huh? All right, well, let's get like 100 then. Do we have the money for 100? Yeah, I think we do. Now, is there a way to buy, like, do we got to buy them, like, one at a time? Oh, and if we're going to get 100, would it be better? We'll just, I don't know. Let's just have them delivered. All right. Well, we can tell because we can do mathematics, right? So like $30,000 worth will be 20. And we really want 90 because that'll give us 100, if that makes sense. Not 90,000, but we want 90 sheep. So 150,000 would be... would be 100 sheep. So that means 15,000 less than that. So 135,000 should be 90 sheep. So now let's come back to here. That killed our percentages, but hey, at least they have something, right? So they'll keep their percentage up. 100% cleanliness. Nice. Yep, 100 sheep. See, I can math. All right, so let's hop back in this guy and give them all the water that they can need. Which was not that much. All right, we have sheepies. So I think what I'll do is I'll finish getting that hay off the field. Might even work on trying to figure out why course play is not working. I must be missing something. I know you could do that in the past. So I'm missing something stupid or some setting, or it's just not something in FS19. Most of the videos I'm finding about it are from FS17, so we'll see. But yeah, after this, I'm not sure which animal we should shoot for next, but we'll be gearing up for the pigs, maybe, just because we'll have, I think, everything we need, or at least enough to get started, because we'll have, you know, we'll have the sugar beets over there, we'll have the corn, we'll have soybeans, we have some wheat already, we'll be able to plant more crops after that, of course. There you go. We got hay. So we're getting close to the cows as well, but I would like to get a way to get some silage going that doesn't involve... Well, we use a lot of water, don't we? Anyway. All right, guys. Well, I'll finish taking care of our sheep, and I hope you have enjoyed the episode. Here, let me hop out of the rather noisy tractor and say goodbye. So I hope you've enjoyed it. It's been a long road getting to the sheep, but it's the first of the animals we're going to get, and I can already see the other ones clogging up my path. My cut-through zone will be all filled up with animals, but that'll be nice. We'll be making some money. I guess at some point we have to get some way to offload wool bales too. All right, well, we'll see what happens. We'll probably try to find a nice lazy auto loader to load up the bales. All right. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you have a good day and take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.